Hello students, here we are back again at Nagesh Karajgi Orchid School channel to study mathematics. And in the previous sessions, we have studied data handling. The exercise that today we are going to study is 5.2. First question, I had explained you in the last session, if you remember. The data tells us it is a survey made on the type of music that certain group of young people like in a city. You can see here the pie chart, which indicates that light type of music, 40% of people like it. 20% of people, they like semi-classical music. 10% of people, they like classical music. And 30% of people, they like folk music. This is the representation of the data in the form of pie chart. What is the question? The question asks are, if 20 people like classical music, how many young people were surveyed? Second question is, which type of music is liked by the maximum number of people? Looking to the percentage itself, we can understand that 40% is the maximum in the pie chart representation. So, maximum number of people, they like light music. Third question, if a cassette company were to make 1000 CDs, how many of each type would they make? Let us switch to the solution to understand the things. The very first question, if 20 people liked classical music, how many young people were surveyed? What is the survey total, survey of the people? What is the count of the people? How many of them they have been surveyed? 10% represents 20 people. Therefore, 100% represents 100 into 20 upon 10. After cancellation of 0, 0 from the numerator and the denominator, the answer comes 200 people. The answer comes 200 people. Means what? 200 people were surveyed. 200 people were surveyed. Let us move to the next sub question. Light music is liked by the maximum number of people. This I had mentioned. Looking to the pie chart itself, we can answer. Third question. What is the third sub question in this? That if the cassette company were to make 1000 CDs, how many of each type would they make? Okay, total 1000 CDs are to be manufactured. Of each type, how many should be made? First of all, 10% of 1000. Students, you know very well, 10% means 10%, it represents 10 upon 100. So, instead of 10%, it is 10 upon 100 multiplied by 1000. 0, 0 got cancelled, 2 zeros from 1000 and 2 zeros from 100. What is remaining in the numerator? 10 into 10. Means it is 100 CDs of classical music. What is the number of classical music CDs that they have to manufacture? 100. Now, semi-classical, 20% of the people, they like semi-classical. So, 20% of 1000, 20% means what? 20. Upon 100 multiplied by 1000. Again, 2 zeros from the denominator, 2 zeros from the numerator, they have been cancelled. So, 20 into 10 is 200. 200 CDs of semi-classical music. 40% of them, they like light music. So, 40 upon 100 multiplied by 1000. Two zeros again from the numerator and the denominator, they are getting cancelled. 400 CDs of light music will be manufactured. Folk music, 30% of the people, they like it. So, 30 upon 100 multiplied by 1000, 00 got cancelled from numerator and denominator, 300 CDs of folk music. Children, if we count 300 plus 400, it is 700, 700 plus 200 is 900, 900 plus 100 is 1000. What the question says, if a cassette company were to make 1000 CDs, how much of each type? So, total 1000, classical music 100, semi-classical 200, light music 400 and folk music 300. The total came to 1000. Let us see the next question. A group of what a group of 360 people were asked to vote for their favorite season from the three seasons, rainy, winter and summer. Total number of people are 360. They were asked to vote for their favorite season. You can see in the table here, season, number of votes, summer season, 90 of them they have voted, rainy season, 120 of them they have voted, winter season, 150 of them they have voted. Looking to the number of votes, we can understand here that many of them, majority of them, they like winter season. The number of votes are the maximum for winter. Second it comes to rainy and third it comes to summer. Now, what are the questions based on this particular data? Which season got the most votes? Winter. Find the central angle of each sector. Third, draw a pie chart to show this information. Looking to the table, we were able to answer the very first question. Find the central angle of each sector means what? Let us switch to the solution. Here, these are the number of votes. These votes we have to convert into degrees. Why? To present them in a circular chart, which is known as pie chart. So, central angle for summer season. How many people were total who voted? They were 360. Out of that, 90 of them they voted for summer, and our circle is of 360 degrees. So, 90 upon 360 is for the votes out of 360, and multiplied by 360, this is telling us that in this circle of 360 degrees, what will be the representation of summer season in the form of central angle. So, 90 upon 360 multiplied by 360. 360 got cancelled, numerator, denominator, is equals to 90 degrees. Central angle of summer season is 90 degrees. Now, for rainy season, 120 votes out of 360. So, it is 120 upon 360 multiplied by 360. Again, 360 got cancelled. Else, I will repeat the thing. 120 upon 360 is what? 120 votes out of 360 people. Into 360, again I will explain the same thing. Circle is of 360 degrees. In this circle, what central angle is this season representing out of 360 degrees? So 120 upon 360 into 360, again 360 got cancelled, is equals to 120 degrees. That is the central angle for rainy season. Central angle for winter season, 150 upon 360 multiplied by 360. 360 got cancelled, 150 degrees means the central angles for summer season is 90 degrees, for rainy season is 120 degrees, and for winter season it is 150 degrees. Now, we are here. It is written in the form of table. Number of votes for each of the season in fraction, because the survey is of 360 people, 360 of them they have voted, 90 upon 360, 120 upon 360, 150 upon 360. Central angle, what is central angle? Central angle is the angle made in the circle by that particular data. So, 90 upon 360 into 360, as I told you, 360 is getting cancelled. So, it is 90 degrees, 120 degrees and 150 degrees. Proceeding further, now we have to represent it in the pie chart. Here you can see this circle. Here you can see this circle. In this circle, we are going to draw a circle, take a radius, keep the protractor on that and measure 90 degrees. It will become the sector for summer. Keeping the protractor on the next part where this summer season data is ending, we are keeping the protractor there, and from there we are measuring 150 degrees. It is representing winter, and the remaining will be 120 degrees, which is rainy. If we add all together, it becomes 360 degrees. Let us switch to the next question. What is the next question? Draw a pie chart showing the following information. The table shows the colors preferred by a group of people. What the table is showing? The table is showing the data of people who preferred colors, different colors they preferred of. Colors in the colors column, you can see blue, green, red, yellow, and number of people 18, 9, 6, 3. 18 people preferred blue color, 9 of them they preferred green color, 6 of them they preferred red color, and 3 of them they preferred yellow color. The total number of people surveyed is 36. Now see, here itself they have explained something. Find the proportion of each sector. For example, blue is 18 upon 36. Out of 36, 18 of them they preferred blue color. So, 18 upon 36 is half. Green, 9 upon 36 means it is 1 upon 4, and so on. Use this to find the corresponding angles. Let us switch to the solution. To see how it has been solved. First column colors, second column number of people, third column in fraction, and fourth column central angle. Fourth column is central angle. Colors, blue, how many people? 18. Out of how many? Out of 36. in fraction form. Central angle 18 upon 36 into 360. 18 upon 36 into 360. 36 ones are 36 tens are. 18 tens are 180 degrees. What is this? This is the central angle in the pie chart. Come to the second one, green. Number of people 9. Out of 36, 9 of them they preferred for green color. For calculation of central angle, 9 upon 36 multiplied by 360. Again the same thing, 36 ones are 36 tens are, means 9 tens are 90. 360 upon 36, every time we will get 10. Very simple thing for the next one, 6 tens are 60 degrees, 3 tens are 30 degrees. Means for blue, it is central angle is 180 degrees, for green it is 90 degrees, for red it is 60 degrees and for yellow it is 30 degrees. This we have to represent in pie chart form. Here you can see 180 degrees means half the circle is representing blue color. Why? Because out of 36, 18 of them in fraction it is 1 upon 2. So, half the circle. Green 90 degrees, red 60 degrees, yellow 30 degrees. How to draw? The procedure is like this. Draw a circle from the center. If you keep the protractor at the center, half the line, that is the semicircle, is representing blue. Keep the protractor here on this and you can see that you have to mark 90 degrees like this. The protractor is kept in this way and here you are marking 90 degrees. This line will represent green. From here, if you mark 60 degrees, it will represent red and the remaining 30 degrees is yellow. In this way, we are going to represent the pie chart. Switching to the next question. The fourth question is, the adjoining pie chart gives the marks scored in an examination by a student in Hindi, English, Mathematics, Social Science and Science. What they are giving the data? The data is of a student who has scored the marks in an examination. The subjects as mentioned here. English, sorry, it is Hindi, English, Mathematics, Social Science and Science. If total marks obtained by the students were 540, answer the following questions. Now, let us see the pie chart. You can see here, Mathematics is representing 90 degrees. Children, just I will remind you, the whole circle is of 360 degrees. In that, Mathematics is representing 90 degrees, English is representing 55 degrees, Hindi is representing 70 degrees, Science is representing 80 degrees, Social Science 65 degrees. Social Science 65 degrees. What are the questions asked? In which subject did the student score 105 marks? They have given a hint here. For 540 marks, the central angle is 360 degrees. So, for 105 marks, what is the central angle? This is the hint that is given to us. Second question, how many more marks were obtained by the student in mathematics than in Hindi? From the pie chart, you can see the student has scored maximum marks in mathematics. Below to that, he has scored in science, then in Hindi, then in social science, and lastly, it is English. The third question, in the second question, I will just re-explain the second question. How many more marks were obtained? How many more marks were obtained? Where there is a comparison and they are asking how many more marks were obtained in mathematics than in Hindi. Whatever he scored in Hindi, than that, how much more he got in mathematics? This is the question. Third question they are asking, examine whether the sum of the marks obtained in social science and mathematics is more than that in science and Hindi. They are saying just study the central angles. They are asking not to calculate. They are not expecting that we should calculate. They are saying examining whether the sum means the addition of the marks in social science and mathematics is more than that in science and Hindi. Social science 65 degrees, mathematics 90 degrees. Together it comes to 155 degrees. Agreed, my dears? What about science and Hindi? Science 80, Hindi 70. Total degrees it goes to 150. This is going to 155, this is going to 150. Which one 155? Mathematics and social science together it is 155 degrees. And Hindi and science it is going for 150 degrees. Obviously, yes, the sum of the marks obtained in social science and mathematics is more than science and Hindi. Now, let us see these calculations. First question and second question that I've been asked to calculate. Switching to the solution, mathematics 90 degrees, social science 65, science 80, Hindi 70, English 55. Marks obtained. Now, 90 degrees out of 360 degrees into total marks 540. So, 9 ones are 9, 9 fours are 36. 1/4 of 540 is equals to 135. Means what? The marks obtained in mathematics is 135. 65 upon 360 into 540, after cancellation, we are getting 97.5 marks in social science. In science, with the same way of calculation, we are getting 120 marks. In Hindi, we are getting 105 marks, and in English, 82.5 marks. The calculation shows these are the marks that we have calculated just now. The student scored 105 marks in Hindi, marks obtained in mathematics is 135. So, marks obtained in Hindi, what is the difference? 135 minus 105, 30. So, 30 more marks were obtained by the student in mathematics than in Hindi. Coming to the third sub-question, that by pie chart we had studied, that sum of the marks in social science and mathematics, 97.5 plus 135 is equals to 232.5. the sum of the marks in science and Hindi 120 plus 105 is equals to 225. So, what is the answer? Yes, the sum of the marks in social science and mathematics is more than that in science and Hindi. Looking to the pie chart itself, we had understood it, and after calculation of the marks, it is very clear. Let us switch to the next question. That is the fifth question. The fifth question, the number of students in a hostel speaking different languages is given below. Display the data in a pie chart. Children, what is the data? Number of students in a hostel speaking different languages. What are those languages? Hindi, 40 students are speaking. English, 12 students. Marathi, 9 students. Tamil, 7 students. Bengali, 4 students. Total number of students is 72. Total number of students is 72. What they are asking? Represent this data in a pie chart. Switching to the calculation, 40 in fraction it is 40 upon 72, and I want to calculate the central angle. 40 upon 72 into 360 degrees. This 360 degrees has come down. Actually, it should be in the center, or it should be with 40. So, the calculation comes to 200 degrees for Hindi. For English, it comes to 60 degrees. For Marathi, it comes to 45 degrees. For Tamil, it comes to 35 degrees. And for Bengali, it comes to 20 degrees. Hindi is the maximum spoken language. Now, for the pie chart, you can see here, we are drawing a circle. And it is left to you that with the help of the protractor, which angle first you are going to take. Whether you are going to start from Bangla, or you are going to start from English, or any of the languages that you want, that degrees you are marking first with the help of the protractor. And 200 degrees for Hindi, 20 degrees for Bangla, 35 degrees for Tamil, Marathi, 45 degrees for Marathi, English, 60 degrees. So, in this way we have seen, how to represent the pie chart. Now, we can understand how to construct the pie chart on the given data. Or also, we have seen that when pie chart is given, looking to the pie chart also, we have answered the questions. So, today here we shall conclude the things. Before concluding, I will show you once again. The display had gone off the board. Hindi 200 degrees, Bangla 20 degrees, Tamil 35 degrees, Marathi 45 degrees, English 60 degrees. In this way, we have to represent the pie chart. And here we are completing this exercise. I hope, students, you have understood this. How to draw the pie chart, in the previous session I had explained you. So, carefully go through the textbook, you will understand that. study the things minutely and properly. In the next session, we shall continue with the next topic of this chapter. Till then, take care and do your studies properly. Thank you.